This day we remember the contributions he made to the field of neonatology, both locally and globally. As part of the celebrations, we award Arnold J. Rudolph Award to the one of the members of the graduating class of neonatology fellowship program. And we also invite an internationally renowned speaker to deliver the Arnold J. Rudolph Memorial Grand Rounds. First, I would like to recognize the support of Dr. Rudolph's family. I would like to start with thanking the support of Mrs. Myrna Rudolph, late wife of Dr. Rudolph. She passed away in 2009, and she played an important part in Dr. Rudolph's contributions. We are also honored to have members of Rudolph family here. I would like to welcome the Rudolph family here. I would like to extend my welcome to Mrs. Arlene Staller and Mrs. Jennifer Kaufman, Mr. Chuck Kaufman, Mrs. Susan Schweitzberg, and Mr. Cliff Rudolph. Thank you very much for your participation, encouragement, and support. We are honored to have you here. Next, I would like to invite Dr. Michael Spear. Dr. Spear had the good fortune to both train under and work with Dr. Rudolph. Dr. Michael Spear will share a few words about Dr. Rudolph.
And the operative phrase is a few words. I first met Dr. Rudolph. Could never call him Jack until perhaps the last 2 years of his life. I was always Dr. Rudolph, or behind his back, the boss. I first met him as a medical student in 1966. And over the years, I came to learn this wonderful man who never seemed to get angry, always had equanimity. He was a fanatic for honesty. He worshiped knowledge, and he imparted both to all of us who trained under him. I had the good fortune to go to South Africa a number of years ago and visited Baragwanath Hospital, which is where he trained. And whereas Texas Children's has gone up, Baragwanath has flattened out. It's a massive hospital covering many, many acres. And I can't remember exactly the delivery total, but I think it's somewhere around 25 to 30,000 a year. It's a huge operation. Later, when I finished my training, I was invited to come on the faculty. I'm not too sure Dr. Rudolph knew what to do with me. I was from California, and that was totally different than South Africa. But we managed, and we wrote several papers together. Dr. Rudolph was probably the second wave of neonatologists, almost the first. But Marion Avery and others were probably the first wave, but he was certainly the second. And he, along with Dr. Ina Desmond, were the founding father and mother of neonatology at Texas Children's. And when Dr. Desmond went into the developmental field, Dr. Rudolph became the chair or section head of neonatology. At that time, we had two neonatologists on faculty. We grew rapidly to three. And then in 1975, we became four and five, because Jack Kenny and James Adams became faculty. And in 1976, I joined the faculty. So we have a rich tradition founded by Dr. Rudolph, nurtured by Dr. Rudolph, and we are here today, and now I'm very proud to say that we have eight neonatology fellows a year, for a total of 18 in total. And I've been involved in currently training, I think, 230 neonatal fellows. So I